Okay, 32-19 devam ediyoruz de. When you got near the camp and saw the bull calf and the dancing, Moses was furious. He heard the tablets down and shattered them in pieces at the foot of the mountain. He took the calf that they had made and burned it in a fire. Then he ground it down to crushed powder, scattered it on the water and made Israelites drink it. Fıttırmış diyor sinirden. Şuraya bir bakıp geliyorum. Devam diyoruz. Moses said to Aaron, "What did these people do to you that you led them to commit such a terrible sin?" Aaron replied, "Don't angry with me, sir. You know yourself that these people are out of control." Okay diyoruz. Şu X'e bakıyoruz. Sam empty evil demiş. Okay diyoruz. They said to me, "Make us gods who can lead us. As for this man Moses who brought us up out of the land of Egypt, we don't have a clue what has happened to him." So I said to them, "Whoever has gold, take it all." So they gave it to me. I threw it into the fire, and out came this bull calf. Moses saw that the people were out of control because Aaron had let them get out of control, making them an easy target for their enemies. So Moses stood at the camp's gate and said, "Whoever is on the Lord's side, come to me." All the Levites gathered around him. Şuraya kadar olan yerlere bir bakıp geliyorum. Devam diyoruz. All the Levites gathered around him. Moses said to them, "This is what the Lord, Israel's God, says. Each of you, strap on your sword. Go back and forth from one end of the camp to the other. Each of you kill your brother, your friend, and your neighbor." The Levites did as Moses commanded. About 3,000 people were killed that day. Moses said, "Today you've been ordained to the Lord, each one of you at the cost of a son or a brother. Today you gained a special blessing for yourselves." The next day Moses said to the people, "You've committed a terrible sin. So now I will go up to the Lord. Maybe I can arrange reconciliation on account of your sin." Kadios. So Moses went back to the Lord and said, "Oh, what a terrible sin these people have committed. They made for themselves gods of gold." Şuna bir bakıyoruz. Oraya God demiş. Okay diyoruz. "But now please forgive their sin. And if not, then wipe me out of your scroll that you've written." But the Lord said to Moses, "The ones I'll wipe out of my scroll are those who sinned against me. Now go and lead the people to the place I described to you. My messenger here will go in front of you. When the day of reckoning comes, I'll count their sin against them." Then the Lord sent a plague on the people because of what they did with the bull calf that Aaron made. "The Lord, I can't go," diyormuş. Bölümün adı bu. We shall see, diyoruz. Exodus 33. The Lord said to Moses, "Go and leave this place. You and the people whom you brought up out of the land of Egypt. Go to the land I promised to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob when I said, 'I'll give it to your descendants.' I send a messenger before you. I'll drive out the Canaanites, the Amorites, the Hittites, the Perizzites, the Hivites, the Jebusites. Go to this land full of milk and honey, but I won't go up with you because I will end up destroying you along the way, since you are a stubborn people." Okay diyoruz. En azından kendisini tutabilmeye başlamış bir seviyeye kadar. "When the people heard the bad news, they were sorry. No one put on any jewelry because the Lord had said to Moses, 'Tell the Israelites, you're a stubborn people. If I were to go up with you even for a single moment, I will destroy you. So now take off your jewelry while I figure out what to do with you.' So after leaving Mount Horeb, the Israelites rid themselves of their jewelry. Okay, diyoruz. Speaking with the Lord at the meeting tent. Moses took the tent and pitched it outside the camp, far away from the camp. He called it the meeting tent. Everyone who wants advice from the Lord will go out to the meeting tent outside the camp. Whenever Moses went out to the tent, all the people would rise and stand at the entrance to their tents and watch Moses until he had gone into the tent. When Moses entered the tent, the column of cloud would come down and stand at the tent's entrance while the Lord talked with Moses. When all the people saw the column of cloud standing at the tent's entrance, they would all rise and then bow down at the entrances to their tents. In this way, the Lord used to speak to Moses face to face, like two people talking to each other. Then Moses would come back to the camp, but his young assistant, Yoshua, Nun's son, wouldn't leave the tent. Why? Buraya bir bakıp geliyorum. Bu Yoshua şey miydi? Hani bu priestlerden biri miydi? Bu priestler hani işte bunlar tapınağımsı bir şey yaptılar. Değişik her şeyin altından olduğu bir sürü değişik perdelerin, ışıkların cırt cırt yapıldığı yeri gözetleyen insanlar bir şekilde oradan ayrılmıyordu zaten falan. Ondan dolayı mı ayrılmıyor? Başka bir şey mi var? Not sure diyor. Devam. Moses pleads with God. Moses said to the Lord, look, you've been telling me lead these people forward, but you haven't told me whom you will send with me. Yet you assured me, I know you by name and think highly of you. Now if you do think highly of me, show me your ways so that I may know you and so that you may really prove of me. Remember too that this nation is your people. Bu Moses da bir insanları öldürüyor, bir God'la tekrar şey diyor falan. Benim kendi adıma şu aralar biraz sıkıldığımı fark ettim. God olaylarından, bu God olaylarının bu kadar merkezde olması bir tık sıkıcı gelmeye başladı bana. Kendi adıma diyeyim. Öyle bir değişime gidiyor onun için. Şuraya bir bakıp geliyorum. Bu cevabı hiç beklemedim. The Lord replied, I go myself and I'll help you. Moses replied, if you won't go yourself, don't make us live here. Because how will anyone know that we have your special approval, both I and your people, unless you go with us? Only that distinguishes us, me and your people, from every other people on the earth. Buraya bir bakıp geliyorum. Bizi diyor, dünyadaki bütün diğer insanlardan ayıran şey diyor, bizim Tanrımızın bizimle beraber yürümesi diyor, kanlı, canlı, fiziksel olarak falan. Doğru diyor sanırım. Devam diyoruz. The Lord said to Moses, I'll do exactly what you asked because you have my special approval and I know you by name. And I know you by name derken neyden kastediyor ki? Hani Jacob'a Israel adını verdi ama Moses'a bir ad falan vermedi. Evet, Moses'a işte Lord gibi davranabilmek için Lord olma hakkı gibi bir şey verdi. I am the Lord diye konuşabilirsin. Yap dedi Moses'a. Ondan falan mı bahsediyor not sure. Devam diyoruz. Moses said, please show me your glorious presence. The Lord said, I'll make all my goodness pass in front of you. And I'll proclaim before you the name, the Lord. I will be kind to whomever I wish to be kind. And I will have compassion to whomever I wish to be compassionate. But, the Lord said, you can't see my face because no one can see me and live. The Lord said, here is a place near me where you will stand beside the rock. As my glorious presence passes by, I'll set you in a gap in the rock and I'll cover you with my hand until I passed by. Then I'll take away my hand, and you will see my back, but my face won't be visible. Okay, diyoruz. Bunlar enteresan. Çünkü yüzünü göstermiyor özellikle. Çünkü benim yüzümü görenler yaşamadı yapıyor. Okey. Buraya bakıp geliyorum. Görmüyorsa eğer God'un face'ini ya Jesus görecek ya da tamamıyla İncil'in dışında Hazreti Muhammed görecek. We shall see. Devam diyoruz. A deeper revealing of God's character demiş. Enteresan bir olay. Gittikçe daha fazla şey öğreneceğiz. God hakkında falan. How? I have no idea. Exodus 34. The Lord said to Moses, cut two stone tablets like the first ones. I write on these tablets the words that were on the first tablets, which you broke into pieces. Get ready in the morning and come up to Mount Sinai. Stand there on top of the mountain in front of me. No one else can come up with you. Don't allow anyone even to be seen anywhere on the mountain. Don't even let sheep and cattle graze in front of the mountain. So Moses cut two stone tablets like the first ones. He got up early in the morning and climbed up Mount Sinai, just as the Lord had commanded him. He carried the two stone tablets in his hands. The Lord came down in the cloud and stood there with him and proclaimed the name, the Lord. The Lord passed in front of him and proclaimed, the Lord, a God who is compassionate and merciful, very patient, full of great loyalty and faithfulness, showing great loyalty to a thousand generations, forgiving every kind of sin and rebellion. Hayvanların boşuna öldürüldüğü Nuh'un zamandaki olan olaydan başka diyoruz en basitinden. Yet by no means clearing the guilty, punishing for their parents' sins, their children and their grandchildren, as well as the third and the fourth generation. At once Moses bowed to the ground and worshipped. He said, if you approve of me, my Lord, please go along with us. Okay diyoruz. Bir şuraya bakıyoruz. Alexis empty adds my lord demiş. Okay diyoruz. Although these are stubborn people, forgive our guilt and our sin and take us as your own possession, renewing the broken covenant. The Lord said, I now make a covenant. In front of all your people, I'll perform dramatic displays of power that have never been done before anywhere on earth or in any nation. Yılan çıkarma cacuk muhabbeti değil yani. All the people who are around you will see what the Lord does. Because I will do an awesome thing with you. Okay diyor. Şuraya bir bakıp geliyorum. Devam diyoruz. Be sure to obey what I command you today. I'm about to drive out before you the Amorites, the Canaanites, the Hittites, the Perizzites, the Hivites, and the Jebusites. Be careful that you don't make a covenant with the inhabitants of the land to which you're going, or it will become a dangerous trap for you. Buraya kadar olan yerlere bir bakıp geliyorum. Devam diyoruz. You must tear down their altars, smash their sacred stone pillars, and cut down their sacred poles. You must not bow down to another god, because the Lord is passionate. The Lord's name means a passionate God. Don't make a covenant with those who live in the land. When they prostitute themselves with their gods and sacrifice to their gods, they may invite you, and you may end up eating some of the sacrifice. Then you might go and choose their daughters as wives for your sons. And their daughters who prostitute themselves with their gods might lead your sons to prostitute themselves with their gods. Okay diyoruz, yani Jews'ler kendilerini prostitütlemiş olmuyorlar seninle beraber. Böyle bilmiyorum. Birden bir hakaret etmeye falan başladı başka insanların kadına falan. Burada yani güç kanıtlama çabasından daha fazlası yok ki burada. Dali Ord'un diğer gadlara ettiği hakaretler içinde falan. Saçma sapan bir şey. Şuraya bir bakıp geliyorum. Devam diyoruz. Don't make metal gods for yourself. Paraya tapmayın diyor sanırım. Observe the festival of unleavened bread. You should eat unleavened bread for 7 days, as I commanded you. At a set time in the month of Abib. Nisan işte. Okay diyoruz. March, April named Nisan after the exile. Okay diyoruz. Because it was in the month of Abib that you came out of Egypt. Every first offspring is mine. That includes all your male livestock. The oldest offspring of cows and sheep. But the donkey's oldest offspring you may ransom with a sheep. But if you don't ransom it, you must break its neck. You should ransom all of your oldest sons. No one should appear before me empty-handed. You should do your work for 6 days. But on the seventh day, you should rest. Even during plowing or harvest time, you should rest. You should observe the festival of weeks for the early produce of the wheat harvest and the gathering festival at the end of the year. Bakıp geliyorum. Devam diyoruz. All your males should appear 3 times a year before the Lord God, Israel's God. I will drive out nations before you and extend your borders. No one will desire and try to take your land if you go up and appear before the Lord, your God, 3 times a year. Okay diyoruz. Don't, ya böyle bir şekilde hiç güvenesim de gelmiyor God'ın laflarının. Hani dedikleri tam çıkıyor gibi değil. Yani böyle bir şekilde bir şey olmayacak diyor. Tamam diyoruz. Biz de onu uyguluyoruz falan bir şekilde. Ama o şeylerin de sonunda bir gün olacağını biliyoruz gibi bir his var içimizde böyle. Hani böyle bir sözü güvenilmezmiş gibi bir hissi vardı hani orada. Devam. Don't slaughter the blood of my sacrifice with anything leavened. The sacrifice of the Passover festival shouldn't be left over until the morning. Bring the best of the early produce of your farmland to the Lord your God's temple. Okay, diyoruz. Don't boil a young goat in its mother's milk. The Lord said to Moses, write down this verse, because by this verse I hereby make a covenant with you and with Israel. Moses was there with the Lord 40 days and 40 nights. He didn't eat any bread or drink any water. He wrote on the tablets the verse of the covenant. The 10 words. Yani 10 tane kelime yazması 40 gün 40 gece sürüyor. Okay diyoruz. Moses's brightly shining face. Moses came down from Mount Sinai. As he came down from the mountain with the two covenant tablets in his hand, Moses didn't realize that the skin of his face shone brightly because he had been talking with God. When Aaron and all the Israelites saw the skin of Moses' face shining brightly, they were afraid to come near him. But Moses called them closer. So Aaron and all the leaders of the community came back to him, and Moses spoke with them. After that, all the Israelites came near as well, and Moses commanded them everything that the Lord had spoken with him on Mount Sinai. When Moses finished speaking with them, he put a veil over his face. Whenever Moses went into the Lord's presence to speak with him, Moses would take the veil off until he came out again. When Moses came out and told the Israelites what he had been commanded, the Israelites would see that the skin of Moses' face was shining brightly. So Moses would put the veil on his face again until the next time he went in to speak with the Lord. Okay, diyoruz. Exodus 35. Moses gathered together the whole Israelite community and said to them, "These are the things that the Lord has commanded you to do." Instructions for the Sabbath. Do your work for 6 days, but the seventh day should be holy to you, a Sabbath of complete rest for the Lord. Whoever does any work on the Sabbath will be put to death. Don't start a fire in any of your homes on the Sabbath day. Şuraya bakıp geliyorum. Devam diyoruz. Şuradan bir kere daha okuyorum. Do your work for 6 days, but the seventh day should be holy to you, a Sabbath of complete rest for the Lord. Whoever does any work on the Sabbath will be put to death. Don't start a fire in any of your homes on the Sabbath day. Preparing to build the dwelling, Moses said to the whole Israelite community, "This is what the Lord has commanded. Collect gift offerings for the Lord from all of you. Whoever freely wants to give should bring the Lord's gift offerings, gold, silver, and copper, blue, purple, and deep red yarns, fine linen, goat's hair, ram's skins dyed red, beaded leather," demiş. Bu şeydi, dolphin skin'di sanki, or dolphin skins demiş, evet diyoruz. Beaded leather, acacia wood, the oil for the light, spices for the anointing oil and for the sweet smelling incense, gemstones and gems for setting in the priest's vest demiş. Hebrew ephod demiş, okay diyoruz. And in the priest's chest pendant. All of you who are skilled in crafts should come forward and make everything that the Lord has commanded. The dwelling, its tent, and its covering, its clasps, its boards, its bars, its posts, and its bases. The chest with its poles and its cover, the veil for a screen. The table with its poles and all its equipment, the bread of the presence. The lampstand for light with its equipment and its lamps, the oil for the light, the incense altar with its poles, the anointing oil and the sweet-smelling incense, the entrance screen for the dwelling's entrance, the altar for entirely burnt offerings, with its copper grate, its poles, and all its equipment, the wash basin with its stand, the courtyard's drapes, its posts, and its bases, and the screen for the courtyard gate, the dwelling's tent pegs, and the courtyard's tent pegs, and their cords, the woven clothing for ministering in the sanctuary, and the holy clothes for Aaron the priest and his sons for their service as priests. Bunların tıpatıp aynısını neredeyse okuduk birkaç kayıt önce. Bir kere daha okuyorsak yapacak bir şey yok. Genesis'in değil, Exodus'un içinde yani resmen. Gifts for building the dwelling. The whole Israelite community left Moses. Everyone who was excited and eager to participate brought the Lord's gift offerings to be used for building the meeting tent and all its furnishings and for the holy clothes. Yukarıda bir yerde şey konuştuyduk. Nun'un oğlu ne diye oradan çıkmadı diye, Aaron'ın sülalesinden geliyor. Ondan dolayı çıkmadı. Both men and women came forward. Everyone who was eager to participate brought pins, earrings, rings and necklaces, all sorts of gold objects. Everyone raised an uplifted offering of gold to the Lord. And everyone who had blue or purple or deep red yarn or fine linen or goat's hair or ram's skins dyed red or beaded leather brought them. Everyone who could make a gift offering of silver or copper brought it as the Lord's gift offering. Everyone who had acacia wood that could be used in any kind of building work brought it. All the skilled women spun cloth with their hands and brought what they had spun in blue and purple and deep red yarns and fine linen. All the women who were eager to use their skill spun the goddess' hair. The chiefs brought gemstones and gems to be set in the priestess' vest and the chest pendant, spices and oil for light and for the anointing oil and for the sweet smelling incense. All the Israelite men and women who were eager to contribute something for the work that the Lord had commanded Moses to do brought it as a spontaneous gift to the Lord. Okay, diyoruz. Şuraya geçmeden hemen bir geliyorum. Devam diyoruz. Moses introduces Bezalel and Oholiba. Then Moses said to the Israelites, look, the Lord has chosen Bezalel, Uri's son and Hur's grandson from the tribe of Judah. The Lord has filled him with the divine spirit that will give him skill, ability, and knowledge for every kind of work. He will be able to create designs, do metal work in gold, silver, and copper, cut stones for setting, carve food, do every kind of creative work, and have the ability to teach others. Both he and Oholibab, Ahisamash's son from the tribe of Dan, have been given the skill to do every kind of work done by a gem cutter or a designer or a needle worker in blue, purple, and deep red yarns, and in fine linen or a weaver or anyone else doing work or creating designs. Okay, diyoruz. Exodus 36. Let Bezalel, diyor, evet, Oholibab, and every other skilled worker whom the Lord has given skill, ability, and knowledge for the work of building the sanctuary do all that the Lord has commanded. Moses then called together Bezalel, Oholibab, and every skilled person whom the Lord had given skill and who was eager to come and do the work. Moses gave them all the gift offerings that the Israelites had contributed to the work on the sanctuary. They kept bringing him spontaneous gifts, morning after morning. Finally, all the skilled workers building the sanctuary left their work that they were doing one by one to come and say to Moses, the people are contributing way too much material for doing the work that the Lord has commanded us to do. So Moses issued a command that was proclaimed throughout the camp. Every man and woman should stop making gift offerings for the sanctuary project. So the people stopped bringing anything more, because what they had already brought was more than enough to do all the work. Tabii bunlar kuzuya, koyuna, öküz yavrusuna, whatever, taptılar falan. Çok pişmanlar şu an. Kendilerini affettirmek için Moses onlara stop diyene kadar gift offeringleri yapmaya devam ettiler kadar diyoruz. Okay. Construction of the dwelling. All the skilled workers made a dwelling out of 10 curtains of fine twisted linen and blue, purple, and deep red yarns, with figures of winged heavenly creatures worked into their design. Each curtain was 42 feet long and 6 feet wide. All the curtains were the same size. They joined 5 of the curtains to each other and joined the other 5 curtains to each other. They made loops of blue thread on the edge of the outer curtain of the first set. They did the same on the edge of the outer curtain of the second set. Buraları da okuduyduk. Bir kere daha yazıyor. Onun için okuyoruz. They made 50 loops on the one curtain and 50 loops on the other curtain that was in the second set. Their loops were opposite each other. They also made 50 gold clasps, and they used the clasps to join the curtains to each other so that the dwelling was one whole structure. They also made curtains of goats' hair for a tent over the dwelling. They made 11 curtains. Each curtain was 45 feet long, and each curtain 6 feet wide. All 11 curtains were the same size. They joined 5 curtains together and the 6 other curtains together. They made 50 loops on the edge of the other curtain of the one set, and 50 loops on the edge of the other set of curtains. They made 50 copper clasps to join the tent together, so that it would be one whole structure. They also made a covering for the tent of Ramses' skins dyed red, and an altar covering of beaded leather. Okay, diyoruz. Then they made acacia wood boards to stand upright as a frame for the dwelling. Each board was 15 feet long and 27 inches wide. Each board had 2 pegs for joining them to each other. They did this for all the dwellings' boards. They made 20 boards for the dwelling's southern side. They made 40 silver bases under the 20 boards, with 2 bases under the first board for its 2 pegs. 2 bases under the next board for its 2 pegs, and so on. For the dwelling's other side on the north, they made 20 boards and 40 silver bases, 2 bases under the first board, 2 bases under the next board, and so on. For the back of the dwelling on the west, they made 6 boards. They made 2 additional boards for the dwelling's rear corners. They were spread out at the bottom, but joined together at the top with 1 ring. In this way, these 2 boards formed the 2 corners. And so there were 8 boards with their 16 silver bases, with 2 bases under every board. Okay, diyoruz. They also made acacia wood bars, 5 for the boards on one side of the dwelling, 5 bars for the boards on the other side of the dwelling, and 5 bars for the boards on the back wall of the dwelling on the west. They made the middle bar, which was halfway up the boards, run from one end to the other. They covered the bars with gold. They made gold rings to house the bars and covered the bars with gold. They made a veil of blue, purple, and deep red yarns and fine twisted linen, with figures of winged heavenly creatures worked into its design. They made for it 4 acacia wood posts covered in gold with gold hoops, and cast 4 silver bases for them. They made a screen for the entrance to the tent of blue, purple, and deep red yarns and fine twisted linen, decorated with needlework. They made its 5 posts with hoops. They covered their tops and bands with gold, but made their 5 bases out of copper. Okay, diyoruz. Building the chest containing the covenant document. Direkt okuduk. Niye tekrar okuyoruz? I have no idea. Exodus 37. Bezalel made the chest of acacia wood. It was 45 inches long, 27 inches wide, and 27 inches high. He covered the chest with pure gold inside and out, and made a gold molding all around it. He cast 4 gold rings for it and put them on its 4 feet, 2 rings on one side and 2 rings on the other. He made acacia wood poles and covered them with gold. He put the poles into the rings on the chest's sides to use to carry the chest. Devam diyoruz. He made a cover for the chest out of pure gold, 45 inches long and 27 inches wide. He made 2 winged heavenly creatures of hammered gold for the 2 ends of the cover. one winged heavenly creature at one end and one winged heavenly creature at the other. He placed the winged heavenly creatures at the cover's two ends. The winged heavenly creatures spread out their wings above, shielding the cover with their wings. The winged heavenly creatures faced each other toward the cover's center, constructing the table and lampstand. He also made a table of acacia wood, 3 feet long, 18 inches wide, and 27 inches high. He covered it with pure gold and made a gold molding all around it. He made a frame around it that was 4 inches wide and gold molding around the frame. He made 4 gold rings for the table. He fastened the rings to the 4 corners at its 4 legs. The rings that housed the poles used for carrying the table were close to the frame. He made the poles used to carry the table out of acacia wood, and he covered them with gold. He made the containers of pure gold that were to be on the table, its plates, dishes, bowls, and jars for pouring drink offerings. He also made a lampstand of pure hammered gold. The lampstand's base, branches, cups, flowers, and petals were all attached to it. It had 6 branches growing out from its sides, 3 branches on one side of the lampstand, and 3 branches on the other side of the lampstand. One branch had 3 cups shaped like almond blossoms, each with a flower and petals. And the next branch also had 3 cups shaped like almond blossoms, each with a flower and petals. A total of 6 branches grew out of the lampstand. In addition, on the lampstand itself, there were 4 cups shaped like almond blossoms, each with its flower and petals. There was a flower attached under the first pair of branches, a flower attached under the next pair of branches, and a flower attached under the last pair of branches. Their flowers and their branches were attached to it. The whole lampstand was one piece of pure hammered gold. He made its 7 lamps and its tongs and its fire pans out of pure gold. He made the lampstand and all its equipment from pure gold, weighing 1 kikar, okay, diyoruz, making the incense altar, incense, and oil. He made the incense altar out of acacia wood. The altar was square, 18 inches long by 18 inches wide. It was 3 feet high, and its horns were permanently attached. He covered it with pure gold, including its top, all its sides, and its horns. He also made a gold molding all around it. He made 2 gold rings, and he attached them under the molding on 2 opposite sides of the altar. They housed the poles used to carry it. He made the poles of acacia wood, and he covered them with gold. He also made the holy anointing oil and the pure sweet-smelling incense like a skilled perfume maker, making the altar for entirely burned offerings, Nemish. Exodus 38. He made the altar for entirely burned offerings out of acacia wood. The altar was square, 7.5 feet long and 7.5 feet wide. It was 4.5 feet high. He made horns for it, 1 horn on each of its 4 corners. Its horns were attached to the altar, and he covered it with copper. He made all the altar's equipment, the pails, the shovels, the bowls, the meat forks, and the trays. He made all its equipment out of copper. He made a grate for the altar of copper mesh underneath its bottom edge and extending halfway up to the middle of the altar. He made four rings for each of the four corners of the copper grate to house the poles. He made the poles out of acacia wood, and he covered them with copper. He put the poles through the rings so that the poles were on the two sides of the altar when it was carried. He made the altar with planks, but hollow inside. He made a copper wash basin with its copper stand from the copper mirrors among the ranks of women assigned to the meeting tent's entrance. Constructing the dwelling's plaza, he also set up the courtyard. The courtyard's south side had drapes of fine twisted linen stretching 150 feet with 20 posts, 20 copper bases, and silver hooks and bands for the posts. Likewise, the north side stretched 150 feet with 20 posts, 20 copper bases, and silver hooks and bands for the posts. On the west side, the drapes stretched 75 feet with their 10 posts, their 10 bases, and silver hooks and bands for the posts. The front side facing east was 75 feet. There were 22 and a half feet of drapes on one side with three posts and three bases for them. Likewise, there were 22 and a half feet of drapes on the other side of the plaza's gate with three posts and three bases for them. All the drapes around the courtyard were made of fine twisted linen. The bases for the posts were made of copper, but the hooks for the posts and their bands were made of silver. The tops of the posts were covered with silver, and all the posts surrounding the courtyard had silver bands. The screen for the gate into the courtyard was made with blue, purple, and deep red yarns and fine twisted linen, decorated with needlework. It was 30 feet long, and along the width of it, 7.5 feet high, corresponding to the courtyard's drapes. It had four posts, their four copper bases, their silver hooks, and their tops and bands covered with silver. All the tent pegs for the dwelling and for the courtyard all around were made of copper. Okay, yes. A listing of materials used. These are the accounts of the dwelling, the covenant dwelling, that were recorded at Moses' instructions. They are the work of the Levites under the direction of Itamar, Aaron the priest's son, Bezalel, Uri's son, and Hur's grandson from the tribe of Judah, made everything that the Lord had commanded Moses to make. Working with Bezalel was Oholiab, Ahisamach's son from the tribe of Dan, who was a gem cutter, a designer, and a needle worker in blue, purple, and deep red yarns, and in fine linen. The total amount of the gold that was used for construction of the whole sanctuary, gold from the uplifted offerings, was 29 kikars and 730 shekels in weight, measured by the sanctuary shekel. The silver from the community census totaled 100 kikars and 1,775 shekels in weight, measured by the sanctuary shekel. They gave a beka per person, that is, half a shekel, measured by the sanctuary shekel, for everyone who was counted in the census, 20 years old and above, 603,550 men. 100 kikars of silver were used to cast the bases for the sanctuary and the bases for the veil. 100 bases from 100 kikars of silver one kicker for every base. He used 1,775 shekels of silver. Okay diyoruz. Sen nesin? Heblex shekels of silver demiş. Okay diyoruz. To make the hoops for the posts, cover their tops, and make bands for them. The amount of copper from the uplifted offering was 70 kikars and 2,400 shekels in weight. He used it to make the bases for the meeting tent's entrance, the copper altar, its copper grate, and all the altar's equipment. The bases all around the courtyard, and the bases for the courtyard's gate, all the dwellings' tent pegs, and all the tent pegs used around the courtyard. Okay, diyoruz. Making the priestess's clothing. Niye tekrar yazdınız? I have no idea. Exodus 39. They used the blue, purple, and deep red yarns to make the woven clothing for those ministering as priests in the sanctuary. They made the holy clothes for Aaron as the Lord had commanded Moses. They made the vest of gold. Vest açıklama gelmiş. Come on. Have effort demiş. Okay diyoruz. They made the vest of gold, of blue, purple, and deep red yarns, and of fine twisted linen. They beat out tin sheaves of gold and cut them into threads to work into designs among the blue, purple, and deep red yarns and of fine linen. They made shoulder pieces for it attached to its two edges so that they could be joined together. The vest's belt was attached to it and made in the same way of gold, of blue, purple, and deep red yarns, and of fine twisted linen, just as the Lord had commanded Moses. They prepared the gemstones by mounting them in gold settings and engraving on them the names of Israel's sons, like an official seal is engraved. The stones were attached to the vest's shoulder pieces as reminder stones for the Israelites, just as the Lord had commanded Moses. They made the embroidered chest pendant in the style of the vest, using gold, blue, purple, and deep red yarns, and fine twisted linen. They made the chest pendant square and doubled, 9 inches long and 9 inches wide when doubled. They set in it 4 rows of gemstones. The first row was a row of carnelian, topaz, and emerald stones. The second row was a turquoise, a sapphire, and a moonstone. The third row was a yakinth, and a agate, and an amethyst. The fourth row was a beryl, an onyx, and a jasper, and a jasper. The settings around them were decorative gold. There were 12 stones with names corresponding to the names of Israel's sons. They were engraved like official seals, each with its name for the 12 tribes. They made chains of pure gold, twisted like cords for the chest pendant. They made 2 gold settings and 2 gold rings. They attached the 2 rings to the 2 edges of the chest pendant. They attached the 2 gold cords to the 2 rings at the edges of the chest pendant. Then they fastened the 2 ends of the 2 cords to the 2 gold settings and attached them to the front of the vest's shoulder pieces. They made 2 gold rings. And they attached them to the 2 edges of the chest pendant on its inside edge facing the vest. They made 2 gold rings and fastened them on the front of the lower part of the 2 shoulder pieces of the vest at its seam just above the vest's belt. The chest pendant was held in place by a blue cord binding its rings to the vest's rings, so that the chest pendant rested on the vest's belt and didn't come loose from the vest, just as the Lord had commanded Moses. demiş. Bana ayrılan sürenin sonuna geldik. Bu videoyu bitirmeden önce diyecek bir şeyin var mıdır? Düşünüp geliyorum. 39-22 devam edeceğiz. Diyecek bir şeyim yok. Kendinize iyi bakın. Görüşürüz.